Hello everyone, Daftic with you, hope everyone's doing well. In today's video, I've received some input regarding the A320 landing training, so we'll break down what needs to be done to nail your landing.
Today we're heading back to Nice Côte d'Azur for a visual landing approach.
The explanation in the training is generally alright, but there are just two things that will change from that dialogue, and has to do with the flare and power thrust adjustment. Now, when you're doing a visual landing, you want to pull out the bird and use it as a reference in relation to how many feet per minute you're descending. Also, mind you that this is the default A320, not the A320X, so anticipate some unusual expectations.
We can rely on auto thrust to manage our speed, so we just need to adjust pitch to stay on the glide slope. Fly-by-wire means that you only need to touch the stick when you want to make adjustments. If you return the stick to the center point, the aircraft will maintain the current attitude. Alright, as long as auto thrust is on, the speed will be automatically managed. Throttle should stay on the climb detent. Firstly, focus on the plane trajectory. No need for any drastic maneuvers. Just keep making small adjustments to pitch and roll as required. You can use the screw on the A320 dash as a reference mark to centerline the runway. To the right of the runway threshold are the four PAPI lights, which will help you maintain a 3-degree glide slope all the way to the ground. Look out for the colors when you have them in sight. If the PAPI shows two white lights and two reds, then we're all good. If all four lights are white, then we're too high, while all red means we're too low. When we're down to 20 feet, start to gently pull back to begin our flare.
The PAPI are the high beam lights you see on the right side of the runway. They guide you and help you determine whether you're high or low. Two red and two white lights are what we want. Think of it like this: two red, two white, I'm alright. For white, check my height. For red, I'm dead. If you're about to fall into those, you need to apply pitch correction to return back to the normal path. Now right now, if you look way ahead at the PAPI lights, you'll see three reds and one white. This means I'm slightly low, so in order to correct it, you just need to stop descending. So right now I'm just somewhere around like 100 feet per minute descent. Once the PAPI lights turn to red to white, I'll resume back to my normal descent. Now the lights are three whites and one red. That means I'm slightly high, so like this I have to descend somewhere around more than 900 feet per minute. So let's just do like around 1300 maybe. Until the lights return back to red to white, and then I'll just return back to 900-800 feet per minute descent. Around 50 feet, it's best to flare at that height because you'll be pitching the aircraft at 5 degrees, so you can be sure that you'll make a smooth landing starting with the main landing gears. 20 feet is very close for anything to be done. Your nose wheel will hit the runway first. Apply small corrections to be on glide somewhere around 800-900 feet. Will take you all the way down to the runway without the need for numerous vertical corrections. As you can see, notice that I'm manually flying the aircraft at the slope. The autopilot is off. And also that you pull the thrust lever to idle at 20 feet, not at retard. The computer throws out the word retard to remind you to pull the thrust back so that the airspeed bleeds off while we flare. Now I'm on glide, all I gotta do is make a little bit to the right until we're aligned with the runway center line. Which is right about now.
We're close to the threshold. Move your focus to the end of the runway. When the computer calls retard, that's your cue to set thrust to idle.
Now everything's in good configuration. I don't need to do much correction. All I gotta do is take away all the way down. So it's 50 with a flare.
40,
30,
20.
Flare.
I'm sure let the wheels touch down.
5.
After touchdown, Return the side stick to neutral position. Ground spoilers are deployed, and auto brakes are braking the aircraft.
Unfortunately, it seems unresponsive at this time, so we'll just use manual braking power.
Nice landing. Keep that up, and you'll earn those four stripes in no time.
Apply all that set and you'll be nailing that landing. Remember to follow poppy lights and make sure it's too red, too white, all the way to the runway. Do that and you'll be on the money. So that's about it for the quick landing tutorial. Hoping that shed some light, some informative. If you have any questions, suggestions, feel free to leave a comment down below. Consider subscribing for more videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.